Flight Boss, bitch, you know, for sure. You're now listening to the mind of an Terry Smooth, Flight Boss the Archangel, and I'm here to carry out God duties and motherfucker responsibilities. And right now, we're gonna get into some ancient geometry. Now, I don't even want to say ancient geometry. This is just the basic geometry that we need to understand. Now, for the most part, when we talk about numerology, that come from an ancient system. And this ancient system, y'all could go to my video about the spirit clock and about the nine dimensions and things of that nature. And, you know, with these nine dimensions and things of that nature, when we talk about geometry, this is where you get the number system in all y'all religions. But you have to understand not to look at numbers as an accountant or subtracting type of way. Numbers are actual frequencies. They're actual frequencies. You know what I'm saying? So for the most part, let's get into this. Now we're going to talk about geometry, like the real geometry. So and this is going to explain why there's always two creation stories. Now for the most part, you're never going to get the first story, which is where the premortal waters came from or where the first spirit came from and things of that nature. But y'all know I'm Archangel Uriel. You know we get into all that. But this is going to break down where all y'all Bibles or religions start at, which is the second half. And then this is why y'all always got two creation stories, because the second one to y'all is actually the third creation story. So check it out. It's all about numbering. So think about it like this. It's only nine numbers, 1 through 9. So 0 by default is just the space or the womb, which is your mind. Your brain creates the womb, which is the first body for things to inhabit. That's what you need to understand. Now, for the most part, because as a spirit, things can live within you. But I don't want to get off track. Now, as coming from the zero, which will be that space, the first light, the first physical form, the first representation, or once, or coming the name of that representation will be one. So this is why it's always a one. Now, let's get to numerology, 1 through 9. Here's the thing. We know everything happens in threes, and there's a three sequence. So you have to stay on that trail. And as long as you stay on that trail, don't get lost. The first way you can get lost is saying, okay, next is 2 and 3. You already lost. If you're going to stay on this trail, you have to make sure you're staying on the trail of 3. So if we was to stay on the trail of 3, and we know there's 9 numbers, 1 through 9, we're not counting compound, then you have to stay on the trail of 3 as much as possible, even to the point that you... In your way of counting, you're counting on the third number ahead, not 1, 2, 3. So for an example, the first creation, out of the zero, you get out of the womb, you get the one. So the first external thing that came from that dream, that womb, that world you create with the first brain, mind, whatever. Now, you go to 2, 3, 4. So 3 numbers ahead, it'd be 4. So this will go to 4. Now this is where all concepts come from of the square and all that shit, and square, and it's a learning process. But when you look at 4, like I said, you can't look at it as numbers. Look at it from a spiritual annotation. Now 4 coming from the 1, we know 4 is nothing but 4 versions of 1. You got 1, 1, 1, 1. So now here's where you get confused, because it's truly just 1. It's just 1 boxing itself in. Or boxing itself out. But in this case, we're going to say boxing itself in. So 4 really represents the square, the logic, the fourth dimension. You see what I'm saying? It represents the square, the box we are in, how we can logically understand the surrounding 360 womb we are in. So 4 represents a square. It's that one thing bouncing off and boxing itself in. So it went this direction, went this direction, went that direction, then went this direction. Now, and the womb, that's a 360. But logically understanding the spaces in, it the one wanted to understand, like, what is this zero? So how it logically understood the 360 womb it was in by logically using the 4. You see what I'm saying? Boxing it out. So 360 degrees is still a square. You see what I'm saying? That's why. But it's the outlining of it, how you can shape and form it. So that's 4. Boxing itself in. So that's you boxing yourself in your own imagination. Now the overall God did this. Now you get to 4, then you go to 7. See? 5, 6, 7. That's the other square. Now, with the 7 right there, that's squaring off now. That's a square off. This is why you got commas or check, 7. That's all the same thing. Look at the comma. Look at the check. Look at, it's just 7 in different ways. The 1 closing itself off or closing its, or once it went from the 4, right? It closed itself off in that 4. So when it crossed itself off in its own world that it outlined for itself out of the 360, right? That line, anytime a line go through a square, you could chop it off in any kind of way and you will see a 7. See what I'm saying? So now, that's the first spiritual being. Now, they don't explain that in the Bible. Now, what y'all getting, and what y'all getting, that's the two creation stories, is actually y'all getting secondhand shit. This is secondhand hand-me-down knowledge. This why y'all don't know what spirit y'all worship. This why y'all don't know where it came from. This why y'all just trust and believe that that's the right one. This why y'all go on that one by default and think that whatever one that's saying is someone going against it, you automatically go by that one default without no story on why it was any opposition in the first place. You see what I'm saying? You're going to get to a whole bunch of shit in all y'all religions because they ain't explaining that part. But my videos do an Archangel Uriel. But that was just that little concept. Now we're going to get to every creation story when we talk about the Bible and shit like that. Now we go to 2. Because this is able to relate or create another world or a compound up under that first system. Now that was 1, which was 1, 4 to 7. That squared itself off. Now, here's where we get to the creation stories that y'all get, and the spirit hovered over the waters and all that shit and things of that nature. This is when you realize you're already in something. You in that spirit that was just birth. You were in that spirit dream and imagination from the 1, 4, and 7. Now, for the most part, things get physical now. Now, here's where you get the level of life of all the stars and all the planets and things of that nature. And y'all get indoctrinated and calling them angels and things, which in realms of realities, we can say that. But let's not get lost in indoctrination. They're just lights in this motherfucking sky. Now, here's how that came about. Now you get the 2, the 5, and the 8. So you get 2, 4, 5. You get 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 3 away from 2. And then you get the 8. You know what I'm saying? The 6, 7, 8. That's the, so now here's where the next level of life, the more denser square off, come from. Now, here's all y'all creation stories. Now it's the 2. It's something relating to something else. There's gonna revolve in a relationship, or something relating to something else, or bouncing off, or something coming apart or expressing itself in another relatable way. And so that two goes deep. Being a part of something or making something a part of you, out separating from you or whatever, separation, whatever frequency vibration you could get from 2, devil, separation, relating, coming together, whatever, that's all the frequencies is going to come from 2. Love, all that shit. Now that leads into 3 away, which will be 5. Like I said, we can't look at numbers as counting. We have to look at them as the frequency vibrations. Then we get 5. This is why 5 represents perfection, because it's part of the 3, which 3 is really just 1 coming from the, letting you know you within that 1. But adding 2 to it is letting you know the 2 is coming as relating from something. You have to relate to what you are actually in, the one thing that you're in. So 5 is perfection. 5 is what's in the middle, because the 2 is the relating, and 5 creates the balance between the 2 relating. So that creates the realm, the world, the planet. You see what I'm saying? The star, the in-between. It's not going too, it can see things from that side and see things from that side, from both sides. And it got it from 2, but 2 needed the 5 to understand that it has to do that in a realm. And when 2 things come together, which is in a realm, which is a 3, which is actually 1, which is how we see the 5, which is 3 plus 2, you can't look at numbers like counting, though. The 3 is represents the 1 that we're in, coming from the 1, 4, and 7. You see what I'm saying? And then we're in it trying to relate, which is the 2. We're separate from it based upon the 2, where the 2 came from. So this is the level of life that's being created based upon the planets and shit. So the 5 is in between. It's the balance. It's the coming together. And it's the both sides. Then that goes to 8. 8 is really, you see two circles now. Two circles coming together. That's how you see an 8. It's the affinity. It's the you know what I'm saying? We can keep bouncing off and relating with each other and keep balancing it out. This is why 8 represents a numerology, experiencing the fruits in your labors, sustaining in something, government, being fixated in something, you know what I'm saying? Or pleasures, or 8 just in general represents sustaining yourself in that realm of reality. It's even what a galaxy do. 8 is the physical being and the level of life of a physical representation of that frequency vibration will be like a galaxy. You see what I'm saying? So you have to understand these things at levels of life. Like, the 6th dimension would be like a star. 5th dimension would be like a planet. 4th dimension would be like an oversoul. 3rd dimension would be like all the physical vessels you see here. The 2nd dimension would be like all the inner vessels that you got in the cell life and things of that nature. And the 1 dimension would be like the actual outlining and the directions and the first physical forms that the spirits can take. And the 0 dimension is where the spirits all come from. But we don't know about that realm. We just know we was birthed from that realm. But we got lost in all this oneness that it got crazy. You see what I'm saying? But for the most part, that's the 2nd creation story. From the 2, that's the 1st creation story to y'all, you know what I'm saying, and all y'all religious and shit, is the 2, the 5, and the 8. You know what I'm saying? So being able to sustain itself in this existence, long periods of time. This is where everybody want to stay in the yang, stay in the fire, stay in the light. And this is where y'all heaven and hell came from, which is the same place. But it's the 2, it's just the relating of the 2 space. Y'all can stay with me. Now, here's the level of life y'all live on, right? Here's the level of life y'all live on. The 3, the 6, and the 9. So this is where y'all get all the 666 shit from, the carbon shit. Here's where y'all get all y'all mathematical equations that everything, when you talk about 9, time shit comes to shit, and this, that, and the 3rd. And you know what I'm saying? This is where y'all get all the Fibonacci sequence and all that shit and everything equating to 9 or 3 or coming back to 3 or 6 in some way, shape, or form. This is the realm y'all live in. This is why it's like that. So this will be the 2nd creation story in all y'all religious texts. But really what it is this the 3, 6, 9. What's 3 away from 3? 6. What's 3 away from 6? 9. And what is 3? A surroundings, a 360. So after all those first events, right, when you get the spirit, right, that's the 0 coming into a 1. Now the spirit took a physical body, which is the light, first light or sound, which is 1. Then it had to go through the process of 4, square itself off and go through 7 and make itself a part of something else so it can extend. Then now it got something to relate to. Here's the 1st creation story to y'all, which really is the 2nd one. You got this relating to something and bouncing off. Then you got 5, which is relating within that realm, within that spirit, which came from the 1st, 4th, and 7th. You know what I'm saying? It's 2 things relating within that realm. And then you got the existence of those for affinity, which is 8. The number 8 affinity that y'all see. The more we could bounce together with the 5, with our 2, from the 2 and the 3 is the 5, the more we can stay in this existence forever, which is 8, which is the God see. And then we got the realm of reality we in, which is the 3, 6, 9, which is if you understand the 3, which is the surroundings and your 360 and the world that you are in, then you just understand that 3, 6, 9 just means you're in a world within a greater world within a bigger world. You see what I'm saying? You're in a 360. Within a greater 360 and a bigger 360. And the moment you get lost, you're gonna be like, okay, well, the 3 represents the 360. So if the 6, here's the Lucifer lie in that. See, we could point out all the lies. You see what I'm saying? Now, here's one of the lies you're gonna be confused with. That the 360 is one world and that's your world. And then once a person become a star, which is the 5th dimension, the 6th dimensional physical form of the frequency vibrations of the 6th energy, right? When a person become a star, right? The 6 is 2 threes. So you would get lost into thinking that it's 2 separate worlds. It's just since you're the bigger world, you can control the mini world, aka control the mini people or control the lesser people. You know what I'm saying? But that's really not what it is. It's just one and the same world. That's what you have to understand. So when you look at the 6, don't get lost into thinking that's just, okay, that's just 2 worlds coming together. No, that's really just a greater world. But you would get blinded into thinking something separate, but it's really just 1. Then it's in the greater world, which is 9. How you get to 9 is what? 3 threes. Now, we know 3 is really just 1. When 3 things come together, that's 1 thing. So this is where you get the this is where you get the spirit becoming an individual, which is a soul, and then you get the body icking the habit. You know what I'm saying? This is where you get all forms of threes from, and everything happened in threes. And y'all religion, y'all might call it the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. If you in pantheism, if you into some type of woman religion, you would say it's the mother goddess, then the Father, Son, then the Holy, whatever like that. But really, this is just what it is. You see what I'm saying? It is what it is. Now, the 369, what you need to understand is that's the greater world that you are in once you reach 9. But once you start to think it's separate, you will get lost into a denomination of compound. So you will start thinking that the 9th dimensional world is really less powerful than the 3rd dimensional world, where really they bounce off each other, the 3, 6, and the 9. You know what I'm saying? You don't know which one is greater, you don't know which one is less, because really that's in the realm of reality of its own. The same way that the two, five, and the eight is the lords and the gods of this realm. So that'd be the planets and the stars. And what y'all call fallen stars and fallen angels and shit like that. I drew a picture about this and I did a video about it, and that is so many analogies that you can take from this picture that I drew that video ain't even had nothing to do with what I was talking about, but it's so much, like, you got the picture right here, boom. Now, you see, I was basically talking about this will be the 1, 4, and the 7. You see what I'm saying? So, what you get out of this is, you think this is 3, but you still see the concept of 4. Why? Because from 1, one thing is always going to have two sides. So, it's 1, 2, right? Then, look, it's always going to be something birthed out of that resonate with that on that one side of frequency. So 3, 4. See what I'm saying? So this aspect right here is the 1, 7, 1, 4, and 7. Then we get to the life that it created, and now they had a mind of their own. So even though this may not speak, it just like to take shapes and forms, these motherfuckers down here have a mind of their own. So this is the motherfucking 2 motherfucking 5 and 8. Right? So let's see what we all got in here, right? We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. God damn it! Now look, I want y'all to go to this motherfucking last video I made of this, because this is goddamn shit. That video ain't had nothing to do with this, but yet, it got everything to do with this shit. Why the fuck is it 8 stars right here now? And then you got the 2 ruling ones that'll confuse you and tell you that they separate, but they really just 1. So, but they got lost into thinking that this thing is more than one thing. You see what I'm saying? So this is where their offsprings come from, a different spirit. But really, look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But these two motherfuckers in an illusion. So it's like they create the illusion for these motherfuckers. But really, this is the stars, the fallen stars, the angels, Lucifers, and all that motherfucker that y'all want to call. And then down here, this is your level of life down here. This is the 369. So let's see how many motherfucking stars down here. Now you got that balanced one that came from up here. Then this Lucifer, he jumping down here, because he came from up here with these motherfuckers and came down here trying to tell y'all that he all of this shit up here. But really, he just down here as a representation of all this shit. And since he can be seen and there's no one to speak for this one up here, then goddamn, sometimes you just fall short. Your spirit may fall short and fall under this one because he's the goddamn lord down here. But at the same time, you know, let's see how many stars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, hold on, wait, I miscounted. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And okay, that's motherfucking 10. That's one going in the womb, and this motherfucker makes 11. So this is the duality, motherfucker. Yeah, okay, yeah, the duality, the love, the 2. Remember how we just explained it, motherfucker 2, the 11. So it's really 1 trying to come in a person's of another one. It's 1 trying to come as this one. So it's the illusion that you think is 1, but this one is way separate from this one, but we all motherfucking lost down here to think of that motherfucker the 1. And what's even bad is this motherfucker got soldiers next to this motherfucker, and they got 2 sides to the motherfucker. So you got motherfuckers that's coming from this motherfucker, motherfuckers that's coming from this motherfucker, and there's all kind of shit going on with this 1, 2, 3 aspects of motherfucking life. Flight boss, bitch, goddamn air.